What happened Thursday night is a group of radical Black Lives Matter members went up and hijacked Reverend Stewart's meeting. What they did was they snatched the microphone from the podium and they violently demanded that lovely Warren and Ron Singletary be fired. We are not commenting today on LaRon Singletary's resignation. We are, however, encouraging the mayor to continue to be transparent, as we believe she has. And we want to continue to hold her accountable for whatever she knew. But we do believe that the mayor acted swiftly. We do believe that she responded based on what she knew. This is not a witch hunt for lovely Mayor Warren. What this is a call for unity. This is a call to respect the elders in the community who have paved the way with the civil rights movement.
This is impressive. The fact, the way this young man has taken upon himself the responsibility of the Black Lives Matter movement to extend an apology to me, to UCLM. It's been UCLM's agenda to look at police misconduct, not only in the city of Rochester, but also in Monroe County, and to propose proposals that are going to reform the way the police continue to conduct their business. What happened to Mr. Prude was a travesty in all respects, and it should never have taken place. The police on that cold night, they murdered Mr. Prude. And the murdering and the denigration of people of color has been a historic constant and a pattern in the city of Rochester, from Alicia McCullough, Denise Hawkins, Calvin Green, and Ken Jackson, up until the present time. And we want to put a stop to it. And the only way that we can deal with this is by members of my generation. And not only was that called the Civil Rights Movement, but it was also called the Black Freedom Movement at that particular time. So members of my generation and members of this gentleman's generation, these young people, working together, because there's a torch now that's being passed, a legacy that's being passed. And so we have talked about coming together and working together for total transformation. What happened on Thursday night was inexcusable. It never should have happened, because what we usually do, it has been our common practice to bring together people and city officials that the community has some concerns with, have them answer the questions that we feel need to be answered. We want to know why the 6-month gap between when Mr. Prude's death happened and no one said anything. That was the venue for that to take place.
That's right.
Asking the hard questions.
That's right.
And it never took place because of anger.
That's right.
Some have called and apologized. However, they don't understand, according to them, why the police were centered. Well, the police were centered because that's the place we had the seats at. I mean, it's logical, right? And if you want to ask people questions, you put people in the center. We've been doing this for decades.
Wow, yes.
And that's how you get community people holding the police and holding the mayor and holding city officials accountable and transparent. Now, UCLM's position is not to push for the resignation of the mayor. Mm-hmm. It's not to push for the resignation of LaRon Singletary. Mm-hmm. But while they are in office, to hold their feet to the flame.
That's right.
Because you cannot have people making decisions for our lives without our input.
Mm-hmm.
If there's going to be police misconduct, Is there, if there's going to be something that's going on that we don't know about, mm-hmm. we need to know about it.
Right.
We need to know about it. The other thing is this whole race commission. I have issues with that.
Yes.
Because the whole race commission has been appointed by the mayor and by the county executive. Mm-hmm. These are political appointments.
Yes.
If you look at the composition of that commission, there are no community activists
Zero.
Involved None. On that commission whatsoever. So how are you going to authentically deal with issues in the community, in the county, deal with issues of race and injustice if you don't include people who have been involved in this
Yes.
on a daily basis?
True.